post city fraud, there have been talks in various quarters that we should have regulations for managing investment advisory services. Who should do it? Is it RBI or SEBI? Are you discussing this?
Yes, we're discussing with SEBI, but on regulating investment advisors, that falls within the ambit of SEBI. Okay, so that clearly is with them. However, to the extent that banks do investment advisory services, RBI needs to permit, because we're the regulator for banks. At the last subcommittee meeting of the FSDC, we discussed this, and SEBI and RBI are continuing to discuss that issue.
How fast is it?
I cannot really say at this point of time.
Okay. Tell us, you took over as a governor on September, just before the...
Early September, 5 yeah. September 2008.
Before the, about 10 days before the collapse of Lehman Brothers.
Yes.
And that was a different time, difficult time. And 2011 now also is very difficult because of inflation going up, particularly, as you said, non-food manufacturing inflation. So between the two, which period is more challenging? It was 2008 and early part 2009, or now?
Well, every period is
dropping,
a challenge.
Dropping rates or upping rates, which is more challenging?
Well, from a purely policy perspective, as I said last year, I believe that easing policy is easier than tightening it, because you have to be more calibrated.
Yeah.
Much more calibrated on the way up than on the way down. Because during the crisis, although I was on a learning curve, I still am on a learning curve.
That's your modesty. And,
but during the crisis, what was important was that being seen to be doing something. What precisely you did was less important than doing something. Mm. But now, as we come back to our recovery phase, and we get back onto our growth aspirations, precise calibration of tightening is much more important, as indeed we've seen over the intense debate leading up to this policy and after today's policy. So that's the most specific answer. But in terms of challenges, there's always going to be a challenge. I compared notes with all my predecessors.
Yeah.
They said there's never going to be a time when you sit back and say, all right, I've finished business, I have nothing to worry about, so I'm just going to enjoy being governor. There's going to be no time like that.
Also, maybe the matrix is slightly different, because at the time of crisis, the government and Reserve Bank of India worked hand in hand. There is no dichotomy, there is no conflict on the views on growth and inflation, so on and so forth. But when you are actually after the recovery, I think there are always a differences to what extent you are tilted towards growth and to what extent to a price stability, which is the case now, I guess, right?
Yes and no, because yes, we were in more constant interaction with the government during the crisis time than during normal times. But there were always differences of view. There were always honest differences of view, and we have to manage them. So I don't think it'll be correct to say that we were reading from the same page then and that we're reading from different pages now. To the extent that there are differences, there will be differences, and I think differences make for better policy, provided there are mechanisms for managing the differences.
Sir, could you tell us just in a very short way, could you unravel the mystic of credit policy making? I'm asking you because you are the Finance Secretary of India and you are a very important part of budget making process. And here, actually, you are signing off the policy. So how do you do it? What are the inputs you bring in, and how do you take a call?
Well, we've tried to make it as consultative as possible, so that we get all the wisdom that is there in the world of analysis and the media. So we consult a number of stakeholders in organized discussions prior to the policy. For example, we consult banks, we consult financial markets, we consult cooperative institutions, we consult industry organizations, we consult economists. Then we have our technical advisory committee for monetary policy, which has two members of our central board as well as three external members, You just now said that we started putting their minutes in the public domain. Then we have internal consultations. Then we arrive at a policy, and then as a matter of courtesy, I inform the government.
So this last part is really critical in the sense, does the government influence you in your policy making? Like, does it happen like that? You had something in mind and finance minister or the government says, no, don't go for 50, you go for 25.
No, they do discuss, but I don't think, eventually the Reserve Bank prevails, you know, if you have a strong view.
Okay.
But I'm receptive to what the government has to say, and I give utmost respect and consideration to what the Prime Minister and the Finance Minister say.
I met you immediately after you took over, and you did say that actually I want to see the world. You know how I'm here making the policy, and I have fantastic researchers and data processors. I get to know everything, but I'd like to go back, go actually to the factories to see the inventories. I would like to go to rural India to see how agriculture is performing. And even you said I would like to go to the VT station where Ajmal Kasad, that Pakistani terrorist, played havoc and killed so many commuters in this Mumbai terrorist attack. You wanted to go out of your ivory tower and see and feel. And have you done that? Are you doing it?
Yes, to some extent. The outreach program that we instituted during the Platinum Jubilee, that's become a regular feature. I tried to go to villages. I tried to go to frontline districts. For example, in the last 1 year, I'd gone to Jharkhand, remote tribal village. I'd gone to Chhattisgarh. I'd gone a second time to one village in Orissa. Wherever I go, I try to meet people who are on the front line, both banks, state government officials, NGOs, etc. So it's an enormously rewarding experience. I'd gone to the VT station, of course. I've traveled by trains. I took some trains. But I need to do more of this. Indeed, senior officers in RBI too need to do more of that.
It's a privilege talking to you, Governor. Thank you for all your time, sir.
Thank you very much. I enjoyed this opportunity.